appalled at what I heard, appalled at what I saw. The wrestlers were bad, but I know it's not their fault. McMahon won't let it go. He squeezes at their balls. What has Raw become? My dying friends, I watch since 93. This really needs to end, and you could have it up, but the attitude is dead.
Fuck.
I wear this stone cold shirt and wish for better times. Now the promos really lack. Lana and Rusev botched 10 times. I really cannot stand how bad the show's become. NXT is good to me, but Raw is a shit bum. What has Raw become? My dying.
Over 50 million views. You're listening to The Joe Cronin Show.
The Joe Cronin Show.
The Joe Cronin Show.
I hope you hang your mother. This country sucks! This place sucks! CNN masturbated all fucking day. Dude, I will eat your fucking asshole out and then spit it into your mouth, baby bird style.
Who wants to go? Call the show. I'll fuck your ass! I wanna kill myself!
Ladies and gentlemen, the great Nine Inch Nails Hurt, baby.
The Joe Cronin Show.
I want to thank Trent Reznor for the Nine Inch Nails song Hurt, because without the Nine Inch Nails song Hurt, we could not have sang that wonderful song about Raw. So thank you to the great Trent Reznor of Nine Inch Nails for the song Hurt. I really appreciate it. Because that is what Raw is. It is Hurt. Every single Monday night, it is fucking Hurt, baby. It is fucking Hurt. Every single Monday night. So thank you so much to the great Trent Reznor, Nine Inch Nails. And about 10 years later, Johnny Cash would cover that song. But obviously nobody does it better than the man who wrote the song, Nine Inch Nails. Fuck all the idiots who think Johnny Cash wrote that song, because it's obviously a Nine Inch Nails song, and people are fucking retards. I can tell by some of the people in the chat. But anyway, that being said, Raw was a pile of shit tonight. All right, let's move microphones over here. That was, man, I'll tell you what, I'll be honest, I about didn't listen to almost anything that happened after Lana gave that fucking promo, man. That was one of the most cringiest piles of shit. She, like, fucked up, like, 17 words, by the way. Fucked up 17 different words. It was pretty fucking insane. It was pretty fucking insane. I may fucking ban people if they tell me that that was done better by Johnny Cash. I may stab somebody if you keep saying that. I may stab one of you in the chat. I fucking irritates the shit out of me. That old fucking cunt would have never had that song without fucking Trent Reznor. And I'm glad he's dead. Anyway, no, I'm just kidding. I like Johnny Cash, but seriously, that pisses me off. Jake DeMarco is here, and he stole Nine Inch Nails' song. But no, I'm just kidding. What's up, Jake DeMarco? How you doing, man?
Trying to get my voice back, but this show was painful to sit through.
Why'd you lose your voice? Were you sucking your own dick because that show was so bad?
I had to keep myself awake. Sucking dick all weekend to pay the bills, too.
Yeah.
That's how you do it, baby. No, nah, just stupid fucking sinus infection. But all the cold medicine in the world did not make this any easier to watch. Even, you know, you try and avoid some of the spoilers, and unfortunately, you know, you just happen to see stuff. And
well,
I'm thankful
that
I did.
We saw clips all week, too. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but it braced us for the pain that was coming our way. That was the show. This was awful. And I mean, like, dreadfully awful. That Lana segment right off the top gets a -1 out of 10.
It was so long and so weird. Like, it was like, it was so long. Like, and she just was like rambling about stuff, and it made sense at one point, but it was like she said all this shit for no reason then. And then,
and
on
according
top of
to
that,
reports, the plan is for them to eventually get back together. They're going to reunite at the end of this.
That's going to make everybody look like a retard.
Exactly. And Lana said, you know, recently. Apparently a source had said that, according to Brad Shepard of all people, but it seems probably likely that she's not comfortable with any of this.
Oh, well,
you know?
Well,
she
I think
it's
Vince,
either that, though, or sit at home.
Vince wants her to bang Lashley. He hates them. I guarantee it. That's what it is.
And
swear to God.
He's making them travel together. So, you know, Lana and Bobby Lashley have been, you know, with the overseas tours stuck together, and I mean, it's not like they're, you know, this is her real husband, so.
This is so weird.
And no wonder she's not comfortable, but she said it's either that or sit at home.
Yeah.
They put you in these positions that just sucks. The Survivor Series show feels more pointless than it ever has. They just kind of threw this team together that makes no sense. I mean,
right.
Sometimes you have people within the you know, Survivor Series 5-on-5, they have rivalries that they put aside. But this was so anticlimactic and anti-triumphant. You know, it's just like, oh, by the way, that's your Raw team. You got Drew McIntyre and Kevin Owens and Seth Rollins working together. Like, it just, at least if you had SmackDown come in and attack too, and but there's no sense of unity. There's no sense of brand loyalty. It's just, it's a mess. It's painful to watch. It feels like NXT is versus the world. They have something to prove, but they're not hitting any shots back. They're not retaliating. It's not going anywhere. I can't believe that they actually aired this shit tonight.
I'm shocked.
There was a rumor at one point that they were pretty upset with some of the stuff that was you know, going to be shown tonight, and they wanted to try and fix some of it, but apparently that was just bullshit. I had hoped that was true, because seeing some of the you know, cell phone footage and hearing all the, you know, the terrible reports, no one wanted to watch this tonight.
I
can't think of one noteworthy or redeeming quality about this show tonight at all.
it's Ricochet and Randy was kind of sort of a tease thing. Before that, the runouts, I guess, of Raw, sort of Kevin Owens and coming out. And I almost forget the show tonight. I mean, I'm dead serious.
For what, though? That's the problem.
I was watching,
it's extremely gimmicky. You're not telling an overall thing. People saying, oh, Walter, and we saw Imperium on SmackDown, and I feel like that was still not great, but better done than tonight.
Right.
They just did it because they were filming back-to-back, and they had people already there.
Yeah, I had heard that this was going to be fucking horrible tonight, but I honestly can't even tell you what I just saw. I have to go back and look at the fucking notes. I mean, you got to set it up for me, or I'll read the notes, because I'm...
Yeah, you have Seth Rollins saying things like, oh, that little title on your waist. And
that was terrible.
That, you know, belittling pretty much the NXT UK side of things.
Well, I don't care. Like, I get it. I just didn't care. Like, I just did not care about Rollins.
But here's the thing. He's supposed to be the face here yet again. You know, it's just more of his drawn-out, driveling, nonsensical bullshit of him on the mic forever. It's frustrating. That's what it is. You don't want to listen to him go on and on about nothing. And then the match we got, you get this tease of Walter. Obviously, you know, there's going to be interference, but it's like, okay, well, that was fun while it lasted. And then we get to this 8-man tag that was a joke.
Ugh.
They give you all this time in the beginning for the women. That went on way too long, I feel.
Yeah, oh my God, dude. The fucking women's match to open the show was like goddamn fucking forever. They went on
it
forever.
It felt like it went on for 40 minutes.
And then
I know
it was
the match itself was like 18 minutes, but and then still, it was
all
longer
for,
than that.
It was all for nothing, too. It was this big, long match that just ended in shit.
Exactly. That's the whole night. That's this show in a nutshell. This whole night was a big, long nothing that ended in shit.
Becky Lynch, Charlotte Flair, the Kabuki Warriors, who cares, but it lasts 35 minutes. And in the end,
but you have Charlotte and Natalya get a victory over the tag champs the week before.
Yeah.
So why is it Becky and Charlotte now? Oh, well, they have a win over us to, you know, beforehand, so we have to get it back. But why are they getting a tag title shot? You know, just because it's formerly Becky two belts? I mean, so you set up a storyline and then you cancel it. So that's retarded as is. And I get what they're trying to do with Shayna Baszler, but they really, really made Bayley look even more like a third wheel. Because Bayley gets her ass kicked again. They're going to have to do a lot of, you know, fixing here to have Bayley look credible whatsoever going into this match. Because right now she feels like she's just going to walk in there and lay down instantly.
Yeah, I couldn't give a shit. This is one of those nights, like, I have no idea what to tell anybody.
They announced Roderick Strong, you know, is going to go against Nakamura, who's going to, you know, go against. So they're doing the title versus title thing. So, I mean, that'll be a fun match in theory. Hopefully they don't fuck it up.
Monday Night Football right now is way more interesting.
I'm sure.
Dude, the game is tied 21-21 with the San Francisco's perfect streak on the line.
That's nuts.
The Seattle
Last I
Seahawks.
Saw it was 21-18, so damn.
Yeah. I mean, like, there's going to be people calling to talk about that tonight. I can tell. They want to talk about that. That's how bad Monday Night Raw is. And I'm not even the biggest goddamn football fan, but, like, I like football enough that, like, this is, I mean, God, the Raw, people must have been, the fucking Monday Night Football ratings must be, like, fucking jacked tonight, because it's... Here comes Dr. Crimson Apple Hooves. Like, just subscribe to the channel. What's up, doctor? How you doing tonight? The women wasted our time for the first 36 minutes of the show, and then nothing else happened after that. I have no idea what to tell you.
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. That's
Want
it.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff.
The bubbly.
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
So many flaws tonight. Little Caesars is shit for $5. I don't care how good you play checkers, that extra gum will get you a harassment charge, kid. Kate is totally dumping David in Temptation Island next episode.
I don't even know what that is, but the goon, thank you for the $3, goon. And what up? To the goon! I also want to say what's up to all the people who joined back up on Patreon or up their pledges. Thank you to the goon there for that donation. I will get
Super
some shout-outs going.
Jack.
Styles versus Strong versus Nakamura. Fire, 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 fire.
Did that happen tonight?
They announced it. Yeah, that's what I was talking about.
Oh, okay, yeah.
So
I mean,
I'm excited for that at Survivor Series, we knew they were doing the mid-card champion.
Russ's and Lana segment killed me, and so did X Woods.
Why the fuck can't I show you my camera? Yeah, Russ's and Lana segment killed me as well. Fuck all that stuff. Why society, man?
Let me call you. And that's why it's so weird that they're not doing the triple threat for the championships.
I'm going to call you back. This is fucked. Fuck you, Skype.
Joe, you need to do a parody music video channel. They did NXT UK Dirty tonight. Lana is the new Me Too poster woman.
Ugh.
Also, everyone in the chat, search Spaz Phoenix podcast on Anchor and Spotify.
Check out Spaz Phoenix's podcast. He's at the podcast game, baby. And yeah, I mean, dude, I thought the UK guys looked ridiculous tonight. They look like assholes. Spaz Phoenix, thank you for the $10 Canadian. Yeah, I thought they looked like asshole idiots tonight, so that really wasn't a good thing, that they looked like asshole idiots. And they really, it just sucked. It really did. It really just sucked. I mean, the UK people, I couldn't stand the fucking wrestlers there for some reason. Seth Rollins pissed me off. Just this whole fucking night was garbage. There's 155.
They finally announced a triple threat.
Seth Coar KO Drew Ricochet on Team Raw. Thoughts?
Seth K.O.R. I don't fucking know. I hate it. I hate it. I hate the WWE. I hate Seth. I hate them all. Fuck them all. Fuck them all to hell.
Sin Cara, who Nico wants release, he won't get it.
He won't
loudly
get it.
Loudly crying face.
Why society? Thanks for the $2. Even if he got it, what is he going to go? He can't be either one of those guys anywhere. He can't be Sin Cara. He can't be Hunico. What's he going to do?
Superchat. Party.
We'll sit at home now.
This show was Lana's imaginary abortion out of 10.
This show was fucking garbage, man. Spaz Phoenix, thank you for the $2. I give this show a fucking 1. A 1 out of 10.
Yeah, I wasn't kidding with a negative 1.
Fuck this show. Fuck this show. Up its ass.
It makes me wonder why we're not getting Brock, Bray, and Adam Cole. They're doing every other title as a triple threat.
Because they don't want
the main titles.
They can't involve Bray. He'll just kill everybody the way he's been booked.
So let him kill everybody. What hurts there? Make him stronger.
They don't want to bury the other guys, the main champions.
You could do it without burying them and still have a hell of a match.
I don't think they think that. Or they don't know. I don't know, man.
I'm saying, you know, it's fucking wrestling. There's a million ways to make that work and have it be entertaining. Lesnar doesn't have to lose.
No.
Party.
Some twit on Twitter tried to use "Careful, I am a mod" on some of the channels you watch as an argument in a wrestling conversation. 100 brainades.
That's weird. What the hell kind of thing to say is that? That's bizarre. Spaz Phoenix, thank you for the $5 again, man. Spaz Phoenix, I suppose your podcast
people
is
suck.
Your name. Yeah, people are. That's a weird thing to do.
Yeah, really.
Who's the top donator, by the way? I got to put them in the thing. I guess it's Spaz Phoenix. Yeah, Spaz Phoenix. Spaz, let me get you on there. Let me get you on here.
There's just so many odd scenarios at this point that just doesn't make sense.
Yeah, I don't understand, dude. This tonight fucking pissed me off. This is one of those coma nights. This is one of those coma nights. Like, I don't know what to tell you. Like, this was dreadful.
A little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. That's
Want
it.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Epstein didn't kill himself. Raw did. Toaster in the bathtub out of 0.
Oh my God, I'm going to spit this up. The Barracuda. What up, Barracuda? Thank you, my friend, for the $3 and a little bit of the bubbly. Needed some bubbly tonight. The Seattle Seahawks have gone up 24-21 on the San Francisco 49ers, who will have the ball back with about a minute and 40 seconds left. Here we go.
What else we got? Oh!
For the perfect record.
That's it. That's
Want
it.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh! A little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Raw was okay 7/10. Like the opening match and the main event. Like the fact that Randy and Ricochet are teasing a feud. intrigued to find out what is inside Eric Rowan's box. Lashley Rusev and Lana angle is so cringe, but it's unique. Creative, I like it.
Wow. Wow. Dwayne the Cock Johnson. That's got to be a joke.
10.
He is the perfect 10. He is the chairman of AEW.
Hey Joe, first time donator. Love your show. Just flew back from Baltimore. Full Gear was amazing. Live I give it a sounds like Raw was bad. Happy I'm no longer part of it. Keep up the great work. Can we get more AU donations? Airplane.
The chairman, thank you, man. That'd be sick if it really was him. No, but the chairman, thank you, man. We will definitely get more AEW donations. That's a great point. We really don't have enough AEW things. Shout out to the chairman, man. Sean Spears.
Super chair.
That's true. We need to do that.
I don't
that.
Like Cole taking an L from Bray. Middle finger that.
Yeah, Wise Society. I think that's basically what they were thinking. I mean, so it goes against all their other booking, but yeah, I mean, they don't want to get into that. They'll just book themselves into a hole again if they book that, I bet. So, I get it. It's dumb, but it's just more of leaving Bray out. Like, they're building themselves into these corners of forcing themselves to have to leave Bray out. But it looks like he's going to face Daniel Bryan, which is what we said last week. So,
you don't have to have Cole or Lesnar lose that match. You don't have to have anybody lose. That's the match you have.
What are you talking about?
For. If you had them in a triple threat, he said he didn't want to have Adam Cole lose to Bray.
Yeah.
You don't have anybody lose at that. You have one match in the night that ends in not even controversy, just chaos.
Yeah, but that will piss everybody off again. They're not going to do that. That's what the whole fucking problem.
If you
problem.
Do it the right way, it doesn't have to be.
Mm.
There's ways that if you...
No, you
I'm
can't.
I'm telling you, there's ways that you can handle that match where it ends in total fucking anarchy.
No, that'll piss
and
everybody off.
The fans
off.
Would be satiated with bloodlust.
No, they won't. That's exactly what they did at Hell in a Cell. They got bloodlust, and it was like people got pissed.
No, Hell in a Cell, you barely did anything. He kicked out at one a half dozen times, and they hit him in a head with a sledgehammer, which was ridiculous. I'm talking, you know, you can tell there's a good portion of the crowd that loves the hardcore dynamic. Look at everything that happened at Full Gear the other night.
Yeah, but
if people, you go ahead and you deliver, you know, the match ends because Lesnar and Bray literally go to ends of the earth to kill each other.
Yeah, but they're going to get mad at any, like, it doesn't matter. People are going to get pissed. If there's not a decision in that match, that's like the match people care about. People will get pissed.
I think there's a few ways to avoid people flipping out.
Yeah, that there is. Don't have them in the match. like any.
Yeah, so keep them off TV again and
no,
do nothing with them.
Exactly. They booked themselves in a corner with the guy. He shouldn't even be champion right now. He should just have won.
Yeah,
he should have feuds, you know, and he should be winning feuds in like gimmick matches. He should be wrestling
a
guy
who's
not
to be
a
the champ. Exactly.
Right.
But.
He should be like, I want a buried alive match. I want a boiler room match. I wanted, like, all these crazy matches and killing people and doing crazy things. Not fucking...
I'm from sexy transvestite. From sexual Transylvania. I'm from sexy transvestite. From sexual Transylvania. Sexy transvestite. From sexual Transylvania.
What the fuck are they doing to my Japanese waifu Asuka? She's a fucking heel or whatever on Ram and SmackDowns, but she's a blatant retard over gaming and fucking rice cookers on her YouTube channel.
Oh.
I hate you, Vince. I hate you and your SJW shit, Steph.
Jesus Christ. Bimbo Baggins 1969. Thank you, Bimbo Baggins, for the $7. Much appreciated. It's going towards the goal. You guys wanted the goal back? It is back. There it is. If you think Raw sucks, fill the goal up. Still watching the football game here, and I can't get my eyes off of this. I can't get my eyes off of you. The football game's better than this. Jimmy G's gonna make them suck dick.
And a few people said, you know, for The Fiend versus Daniel Bryan, that being better than, you know, a triple threat. I'm not arguing that, but we may not get that yet. They had to change things around a little bit because of what happened with the, you know, the plane delay with Saudi and whatnot. But the thing going forward is they still might have Daniel Bryan. What they did Friday on SmackDown was supposed to set the seeds for their feud after Survivor Series. What I initially heard is that they still want to try and do this match with The Miz. Again, take it with a grain of salt. I think it's a shitty idea, but take, you know, that, whatever. Either way, they tease Daniel Bryan. That's what they should go with. But apparently one of the thoughts considering is that they still have the one-off with The Miz at Survivor Series, and then they go into a full program with Daniel Bryan and The Fiend. I understand that because they don't want to rush The Fiend and Daniel Bryan right away. There's a lot of history there. There's a lot they can do with that. So if you have The Fiend go over him immediately at Survivor Series, it's done.
Yeah. It's going to come down to a kick. Jake, they're about to kick.
Down to a field goal.
This is better than anything on Raw. San Francisco 49ers. 6 seconds. The rookie kicker drills it, and it's going to be tie. And we're going overtime. In San Francisco, we're going overtime. The Seattle Seahawks and the San Francisco 49ers. It's going to take extra time in the gig. I mean, in San Francisco. No, I'm just kidding. But no, this is going to be good. All right, so here we go. This is better than goddamn wrestling tonight. Jake, continue your point.
How far was the field goal?
I don't know, 39 yards. I missed it.
Yeah, Robbie Gould's good, so.
I'm actually. The Patriots are obviously my number one team. 49ers are my number two team, but I hope they lose because I don't want them to be the only undefeated team. No, I'm kind of a dick. I'm kind of a dickhead, Jake.
Hey, can't beat it. Makes you know more logical sense than anything we saw tonight.
I said that a few years back that Jimmy G was going to win a Super Bowl in the next couple of years, and here we fucking go, maybe. But fuck
it. Could happen.
I want to see him versus Brady. I want to see it. That'd be bad. If he beats us, though, that would really piss me off. But whatever. Because he should have.
Yeah, you'll ask for it, and then they'll get your ass beat, and you'll be 47 yards, too.
I'll be really mad. It was 47. Okay, yeah, I thought it was 40. Jesus. Yeah. He made it look easy. The kick was right down the middle. Seahawks are going to get the ball first. And
yeah, he's a talented kicker.
Yeah.
They changed the Survivor Series match now. They took out the Revival. And as Matt the Misfit made a great point with, it was like, you know, who's the best tag team that came from NXT? Because you had the Revival, you had the Viking Raiders, and Undisputed Era. Now you throw the New Day in there, which already feels underwhelming. I'm done with the New Day. I think everybody is.
Yeah, I won. I told everybody earlier.
You know, he peaked. That was it. That's the most we got from it. This Send feels it like such a consolation prize that nobody wants.
Yeah, they need to make Big E, man. I'd book Big E right now as a badass motherfucker. Grab the mic and be like, listen, motherfucker, I'm tired of all this shit, blah, blah, blah. Throw the mic down. I'd make him go full-on fucking, like, make him go, not heel, but make him go just full-on savage. I would give the microphone at this point to Big E. I don't care if he even ends up becoming a mid-carder because of it. Give Wyatt, Rusev and Lana sucks. Give the microphone to Big E. And I want Big E. Oh, I was wrong about the coin cost. Whatever the fuck. I can't talk. Give Big E the mic and just be like, dude, you're gonna be hitting on this point, that point, and this point. I want you to rant on it, and I want you to spike the fucking mic. You know, I want Big E to come out there and be like, you know what I mean? I'm tired of all these fake guys saying I deserve this, I deserve that. I want my release. I want to beat somebody's ass in this ring now. And I want to see the fucking veins just fucking popping all over him. I want to spike that fucking mic. And then when the guy comes out to answer Big E's challenge, I want Big E to run from the inside of the ring and suicide dive or whatever the fuck through the ropes and attack somebody before they even get to the ring. I want him to intercept the guy who starts walking fast down to the ring. You know what I mean? I mean, I want some guy to come out like some jabroni. Like, I want Big E to grab the mic and be like, you know, I want some competition. Now, what Big E Langston wants is some big-time competition, something I haven't had in a long time. So I want right now the best, and I mean the best in the back of that locker room, to get your ass out here and get some of the Big E. Come get some right now. Like, and then I want someone to come out, and I want it to be like fucking someone stupid. I want it to be like Heath Slater or somebody. And then I want Biggie to just fucking shake his head, run off the ropes, and as Heath Slater is power walking to the ring, I want Biggie to dive over the rope and just fucking tackle him. Then I want Biggie to throw him into the fucking wall. And then I want him to bash him in the fucking head with a chair. And then I want him to put the chair over his neck and step on it. And then I want him to dive back in the ring, and I want him to grab a mic, and he said, I said some real competition, not some redheaded pussy. Boom, spike the mic down again. And I want someone else to come out who's a jabroni. And then I want to beat the shit out of that guy. And then, motherfucker, I want goddamn Aleister Black to come out. And then I want them to go at it. And I want them to have a fucking epic fight and a drag down, knockdown fucking brawl. And in the end, fucking Big E defeats goddamn Aleister. And then Aleister attacks him back. And then they have a feud and they have three matches. And it's a great time for everybody. Sorry, I lost my mind there. I'm sorry. Did I mute you? I think I muted you by accident. Oh, no, you muted you.
It's better than Kofi going ahead and being the one to turn heel, as reports say. How nauseatingly stupid is that shit? I mean, God, SmackDown had a 2.61 on Friday. That was up from the 2.5 they had the week before. But they're still crushing it in that 18 to 49 demographic. They were the top, you know, top show for that specific bracket, and that's what advertisers and things focus on. So of course Fox is happy at this point, not thrilled but happy. And as you mentioned before, you know, we've got Sin Cara asking for his release. He joins Luke Harper, Ty Dillinger, Mike Kanellis. You know, obviously Dean didn't resign, so Moxley's elsewhere better. But the thing is, already we heard from PW Insider that they were going to use Sin Cara after the European tour, but now he's going home. He's not working Raw in Boston next Monday.
Goodbye.
So he'll get the Luke Harper treatment.
And now
he said outright, you know, he's tired of not being utilized and used. And it's not shocking. It's not surprising either. You know, it's surprising that he posted his sentiments, because you know what's going to happen. Now they're not going to use you, so.
Well, now, I mean, now he can sit at home and bang his wife or something. I don't know.
I guess. But they just introduced this tag partner with him, you know, and they were supposed to get this kind of angle developing with those two. Another situation that's developing is an attacker stabbed four people during a live performance in Saudi Arabia. The Arab National was motivated because women were performing at this production.
Oh, wow.
So yeah. WWE is sourced to say that they're watching this situation to see how it unfolds.
Why?
Because they had the women perform in Saudi last time, and this guy stabbed four people in protest of women performing. So.
Wow. Did someone stab him back?
No, he was eventually apprehended by police, but...
What a fucking retard.
Yeah, he stabbed two men and a woman and one other person who were all members of the theatrical group there performing.
Jesus. I mean, it could have been a lot worse for out... You know what I mean? Like, for out there...
Oh, it always could be, but it's the fact of people are not... You know, you see some, you know, as far as WWE goes, people were okay for the most part, at least, you know.
Why are they watching? Who cares? Why are they watching? They like, literally.
Because they have to go back to Saudi. They made more deals.
They
sawed like
a man into pieces, like, alive.
Yeah, it shouldn't be surprising, but there's more upheaval about women performing than you were led to believe.
No,
so.
I guarantee it, man. I mean, listen, 70% of the crowd probably was like, yeah, cool, but there's... 20% of the crowd, there's probably...
But that
like,
was the people that went to wrestling that like wrestling.
Right. But I'm saying
everybody
that,
else outside of that building more than likely was pissed that, you know, women were performing in their country.
Well, no, I think it's more like, you know, I feel like it's like, you know, there's a small minority of, like, insane people there, though, that want to, like, do something about it. And that's what I'm saying. Like, I would say,
yeah.
I don't know the percentages. I don't know that much about the Middle East anyway. But I would say that there's at least 10% of the people there that kind of want to do something because of it. You know?
Absolutely. You know, they stick to their religious beliefs, and this becomes an issue for them. So WWE wants to bring...
But that's natural, because then over time, that number should dwindle down and dwindle down, and then everybody eventually will almost accept it, so there won't be a problem anymore.
Hopefully, but you figure at this point it shouldn't be a problem anyways, but that's a whole other can of
worms. Everybody, if you tell 100 people that there's going to be this extreme change, even if it's the right change, those 100 people, you know, maybe 80 of them will be like, okay, that's fine. But maybe 10 of them will be like, this kind of stupid. Like, I don't like this. And then there might be 10, 5, or 3 of them that go, we're going to stop this. Like, that's bullshit. Like, so it's just nature to see that. Like, the bottle being hurled at one of the girls the other day, the bottle that was hurled, you know, that was obviously could have been worse. Wow, the Seattle Seahawks, they just completed an epic pass for a first down. Desperation throw on the run. Way outside the pocket, it looked like, almost. For who the fuck is the quarterback for the Seattle Seahawks? I forget. What's his face? I don't know, man. What a fucking... Oh, my God, dude. What a scramble and a throw. He had nowhere to go. He might have hit Gordon. I don't know.
What the hell's his name? It's Wilson?
Russell Wilson. Yeah, there you go.
Yeah,
oh, man, what a grab. Dude, a grab, avoid the tackle, a spin move to avoid the tackle and get 8 more yards after that. And now they're on the 33. I might be behind some other people. You guys might be way ahead, but... It's pretty fucking crazy. I know most people don't care about football, but after Ross sucking so much dick tonight, I'm actually fucking really interested in this.
If you haven't noticed, I'm talking about anything but Raw.
Yeah, we can't.
WrestleMania 35 actually generated second most income yet for the economy in the New York, New Jersey area.
Damn.
As far as, you know, like visiting or traveling entertainment, the total generated revenue is $165.4 million in economic impact.
Damn.
A 6% increase from WrestleMania 29 in New York and New Jersey. And when you look at the stats, that's $165.4 million in direct, indirect, and induced impact. So 52% of fans stayed 4 to 6 nights at hotels. $23.9 million spent on those hotels and accommodations. It also went ahead and it basically created... The impact derived from WrestleMania was equal to the creation of almost 1,600 full-time jobs for the area.
Damn.
And $6.6 million was spent by visitors to the region at restaurants. So they're saying, you know, it had such an economic boom that it helped out a great deal. And they're expecting to break records at this year's Mania in Florida. So
yeah, down in Tampa, they're going to... Some people won't be homeless anymore. 516 is on the phone. Hello.
You know who this is, Joe.
Oh, it's Nick.
Yep, correct. How you doing tonight, bro? And by the way, the quarterback was Russell Wilson. And I'm excited because I had him and Gordon on my fantasy team.
That's cool, man. Yeah, I figured it out eventually. It took me a minute. Once Jake got Russell, I got the Wilson. We completed it. But yeah, what's up?
I'm doing all right. Did you hear Sin Cara actually requested his release?
Jesus, what, are you not watching the show?
Yo, no, I did watch the show. I'm just saying, did you hear about... I'm a bit late to the show. I'm sorry.
All right,
but
Jesus.
What's your opinion on it?
It's not surprising.
Not surprising,
not
I mean.
Utilized, but it's foolish. I think anybody that has a brain, unless he wants to sit home. I mean, if he wants to sit home, then that's on him. But
yeah, but you want to know what WWE thinks when they say, oh, I want to request your release from WWE? You want to know what that tells me?
What's that?
Did they want to sit at home and make money?
Tells me, oh, do you want an extension on your contract because you were injured?
Well, no, dude. I think these people are like, you know what? I'm so miserable here that I would rather... I heard that you could sit at home and make money.
Yeah, I guess.
In the past, WWE would cut you from your contract. You wouldn't make any more money, and you wouldn't be able to. And you could go wherever, but you wouldn't make the WWE money, and they wouldn't care. Now they don't want you to go anywhere else because they know about their competition, so they won't fire you completely, but they won't play you essentially. Oh my God! Seattle just threw an interception in the red zone. What the fuck are they doing?
What? My God! Come on!
An interception in the red zone, 4 feet away from the end zone. Russell Wilson.
Dude, is Daryl fucking Bevel the offensive coordinator in this game? Like, why would you?
Oh my God, Almighty!
That's
what
maddening.
The fuck?
It's the Super Bowl all over again, you know.
Yeah,
you have some of the best running backs, and
you're in the red zone. You're in the red zone. What are you doing? Russell Wilson
Why
throws
would
a
you throw the ball.
What he throws in a four-man coverage, four-man coverage on one guy.
That's definitely leading to a.
That was fucking dude. I don't get. Man, like, come on. I feel like...
Wow, Russell Wilson is a retard. Like, what is this? Throw the ball away.
Dude.
Joe, he's not a retard.
Same old Pete Carroll, bro.
He bet against himself. That's what
he
it is.
He bet against himself. Yeah, he bet against himself.
He pulled a Pete Rose in football, bro.
Wow, man.
He pulled a Pete Rose in football.
Why would you not run, like, three running plays in a row there, or at least
and
two?
And you have Rashad Penny, who's been decent this year.
I would run all short routes. Why would you run this post-fucking lob... Oh, my God.
He underthrew it, too, by a great deal.
He underthrew it. Yeah, I mean, you would throw it too far. If anything, you would throw it like where almost nobody could catch it. He threw it trying to lead the guy into the end zone in four-man coverage, or at least three-man. I'll give you three. There's three guys around him.
I don't get that. I don't get that at all, man.
Wow.
Fuck.
Whoa.
I feel like fucking Seth Rollins' chest right now, like I've been beaten to a pulp.
God, somebody said God told him to do it.
Yeah, really.
Oh, is he religious?
Oh, God. I
wow.
And by the way, I don't know if you guys saw this. Did you see what WWE on Fox retweeted?
No, what's that?
No, what'd they say now?
On Ryan Satin, with Ryan Satin, he said, Rusev apparently tried to have sex with Lana in WrestleMania 31's tank. Now we know why his head wasn't in the game when he lost to John Cena. WWE on Fox actually retweeted that.
Ryan Satin is a mongoloid asshole. That's just fucking a hate.
Yeah, he's a fucking retard. Like, not Tommy level retard, but he, you know, he's less of a slob than Tommy is.
I don't know.
But dude, I don't know.
I'd rather live with Tommy than Ryan Satin, to be honest.
Fair point. That's a fair point too. Let's get back to Raw. I don't get why. Why is it that they have to give freaking Kevin Owens not only the stunner, but the crotch chop? Like, why do they always got to give Kevin Owens the old stuff?
That was wicked funny, dude. Kevin Owens is Degeneration Austin. It's unbelievable. That was so funny. Nick, thanks for the call. Yeah, I saw that. I was like, hey, he's Degeneration Stone Cold or whatever. Like, he's got the best two
Super
gimmicks.
Super chat.
New day are in 2014 Shield territory. Nothing left.
Yep. It's time to break that up. It's time for Big E to go his own way. Never a better opportunity.
It's been that way for a long time, though.
Yeah, this is the perfect opportunity.
He'd like to think that maybe this company will be better after Vince McMahon is dead, but the fact is it's going to get taken over by his idiotic daughter and his doofus son-in-law and the rest of his stupid family. I called it years ago.
CM Punk, you were right about everything else. I don't know why you wouldn't be right about this, I guess. I mean, you are a prick for always never coming back and teasing everybody and basically walking away, but I think you're right, CM Punk. I believe you might be right.
Super chat.
Undisputed era equals draped in gold, baby. Sign of the horns, okay hand.
That's true. Why Society, thank you for the $2 super chat, Why Society. What up, Brandon Harbin in the chat?
Super chat.
Spiderland.
Super chat.
What's up?
JD versus Russo versus Riddle versus Nick Battle of the Bros.
Yeah, I suppose so, bro. Fuck you, bro. Fuck me, bro. Yeah, the Raw was just Drew McIntyre won a match against Sin Cara. That was good. That was a good idea. One-on-two handicap match.
But the thing is with that, I mean, it's like, all right, he's building up wins, but for what? What are they doing with him?
I don't know.
He's going to be part of Team Raw. Whoopee shit. Well, he's another one you can't get
behind.
I'm
not
going to
crap on that, though, because at least it's a step in the – it's the right move.
I mean,
it's not like a bad
move.
We've
seen it time and time again where he gets like all these small, quick wins. They accumulate, and then all of a sudden it gets to be heading towards something important, and
Raw
it just gets dropped
the living
out.
Bits of a zombie woman's fetus out of 10.
Spaz Phoenix, thanks, man. That message was so weird that it just cut off half of what you said.
Yeah, I didn't even see it.
That's so weird. But no, I mean, like, I don't know. I'm not going to cry. I just, like, whatever. I don't care. But yeah, cool.
That's the thing. It's not bad. You just don't give a shit. Here's a great point they have the Viking Raiders come out against, you know, Andrews and Flash Morgan and Webster. And these guys are really popular in NXT UK. They're a babyface team. You know, people enjoy them, especially in NXT UK. They're in their, you know, their hometown, quote unquote, home country, whatever, homeland, whatever you want to put it, but still hometown heroes. And for weeks now, you know, the Viking Raiders are faces. You've had them booked as faces. You have them beat, squash, whatever you want to call it, team after team. You know, the Polo Boys and the Chicago Cubs guys there and all this stuff. And then you expect them to get cheered tonight after they're squashing and beating a babyface duo that's in their hometown. Like, why book it like that? This is supposed to be your face tag team champions. You're putting them against other faces who are, you know, overtly over because they're in their homeland. How does that make any sense? Why would you do that?
I don't understand.
It's you've done all this work to set them up as like these impressive, you know, talented, strong champions, and then you have them lose at the Saudi show. So already they're hindered there. But then you get a few more squash matches in, and then from there, now you get this shit.
Right.
You know, like you said the other day with AEW, where, you know, all the hot tag is missed, and you're getting sympathy for a heel team. Same idea here. You're getting booed for your face champions.
Right.
You don't want that to resonate with the crowd.
Dude, this whole show was an anomaly tonight that I don't even want to count. Like, I will never remember anything that happened tonight. I just feel like get to next week and try to figure out what they're doing next week, because this
next week
is the
go home show for Survivor Series, right?
Yeah.
So I mean, they really gotta get in motion at that point. And here's the thing, you know, Becky, I said it on Twitter, but I stand behind it. I'm not a total hater of hers or anything like that. I'm more indifferent, but I said she became stale and stagnant because if you look at her entire run so far, you have this elephant in the room that is Ronda Rousey. I mean, you have that sloppy pin finish at Mania.
Right.
So, it you know, really it was a two count. She beat her, but we all kind of just went along with it.
Can you believe that's the ending to the main event at WrestleMania?
Yeah, the first women's main event, and you get that crap pin.
That is so
that
bad.
That terrible botch that they completely, you know, hide and, you know, you only hear the three count. You no longer see it. So since Mania, all the people that Becky has faced, Sasha is, in my eyes, the only credible contender that she's gone against, and that was wildly short-lived. Yeah, even if you're saying Sasha, you know, before she got injured and all that stuff after the Hell in a Cell match, she was still booked to lose, so that didn't matter. Lacey, as good as she is, I really enjoy her. She wasn't established. She was too new, too green, you know, in the eyes of the fans. You knew she wasn't going to beat. You know, she wasn't going to take down the man. And her and Charlotte have this really weird on-again, off-again relationship that's really confusing and so convoluted. One week they're killing each other. The next week, oh, it's we respect each other and we're teaming up. So she hasn't had any, you know, substantial feuds. The one that she had, they used as a blow-off. And it's all, I know, building towards her needing to face Ronda Rousey again. But everything until then is a holding pattern. So we're just getting the same thing each week with her talking up. Now, her and Baszler is interesting. But because it's a triple threat with Bayley, it takes away from it. It really does in my eyes anyways. It's not that I'm not looking forward to the match. But we know Bayley's getting pinned. If anything different happens in that, then you know, my God, I'll be truly shocked. But
he missed the field goal. It goes wide. The 49ers miss the field goal attempt from 50 yards.
Oh, shit. Damn. Didn't expect that to happen. Usually their special teams is spot on. And then you consider everything with this Lana and Rusev stuff, you know, hearing that they're not comfortable with doing this angle. You hear what she said, and as you mentioned before, she messed up so many times, and her, you know, initially saying, oh, don't judge me. And, you know, I'm here telling you about my beautiful sex that I had with my lover, Bobby Lashley, my boyfriend. But then she's labeling Rusev as the sex addict as she goes on and on and on about how great the sex is with Bobby Lashley. Then she says she's 9 weeks pregnant and talking about having a 15-pound baby. I was, you know, I really wish the fans tore that whole thing apart more. But that's the standout for tonight, because that's the pinnacle of entertainment that they thought was good enough to be on our TVs. That's what they thought they were going to, you know, lead with. And then as she's walking up the ramp, you hear her, "I cannot believe he believes I was pregnant." So already they scrapped the angle before it started.
Yeah, that was the most
the
annoying
pregnancy
thing.
Is already over.
That was very annoying and stupid. Like,
so
it went on
you're
way
pregnant
too
for
long.
What? To get the blind attack on him, which wasn't even like a huge attack. If they went and like really destroyed Rusev here, they put him through tables and, you know, threw him off the stage, and, you know, he was bleeding, and, oh, well, I just said he was pregnant to really distract him and screw with his head so we could destroy him. I mean, it still wouldn't be good, but at least it would make a little bit of sense. But she jumped on his back to claw his eyes. So you needed to be pregnant to do that? Like, there was no justification to pull that out.
I mean, I get that it's all just to shit on him and, like, be psychological, but who would ever do this and then get back together? And who?
Yeah, and to Rusev, know that they're going to be reunited at some point. But I'm saying you're going that far to say you're pregnant to call it off in the same time. So what is the psychological game you're playing is already ruined because you said it doesn't. It's not true already. Well, in 90 seconds, you went from expecting to yield abortion clinic. Like, it doesn't work.
I don't know. I have no idea what they're doing. This is the dumbest shit ever. Lana went on way too long. She botched like 9 words.
Yeah.
She went on and on.
No one wants to boo.
He wasn't good on the mic either. Bobby's weird. Like, the whole fucking thing is
no one wants to boo Rusev.
Stupid.
No one wants to boo Asuka or, you know, Sane. They want to cheer the Kabuki Warriors. You can tell. But they're being booked as heels, so it's just an uncomfortable situation. Asuka's Kana-chan YouTube thing is funny because it's endearing. You know, she's just
they're going to tell her to stop doing it soon because, like, everybody likes it.
That's the problem. So they'll intervene with that.
I mean, maybe. I'm just saying. People like it.
That's the thing. If they want her to be a heel, I could see them making her stop. Drew McIntyre, like you said, he wins in a you know, very quick match. And Sin Cara's now not going to be on TV anymore. They ruined even people that were still defending and enjoying the 24/7 title. I haven't enjoyed it in 3 months now.
Yeah, it's over sadly. For me, too. This is done.
But people that were still defending it, being like, oh, I still even like the runaround stuff. I saw them tweet tonight, like, I'm done. I'm checking out. You failed with this, you know, endeavor. This idea is a waste. There's nothing to be gained here. That's sad to hear that you had people, you know, defending this for weeks, still trying to hold on to some semblance of hope, and they shit on. I mean, the crowd booed incessantly because they didn't air anything that happened backstage. They didn't get to see the women's locker room part and all this, and it was just, you know, that's it.
Right.
That sucks. The whole thing is just ruined. There's so much they can do with this belt. They have free reign. They have how many talk shows now? They, you know, they got the bump, they've got backstage, they've got all these pre-shows, they have YouTube with 50 million subscribers, and the videos were huge hits for them. They were getting 10 million views on a golf course pin or an airplane title change. You know, it was working. People were excited to see something somewhat different, and they just have them either chase each other or that's it. There's no creativity allowed whatsoever. No one wants to hear Rollins on the mic. So, I mean, literally so far, we have a women's segment that went way too long and a match that ended in shit. We have a shitty backstage interaction between Mr. Superhero and the OC. Drew McIntyre's shitty short match. No sign of Catalina either, which is weird because they just threw her away. Now we know why. We got the 24/7 bullshit, which leads into Seth Rollins going on and on about, you know, oh, I already lost to The Fiend, and this is my show, and then people in the crowd are chanting NXT. This is supposed to be your top face, your leader for Raw, your captain for Survivor Series. And, you know, you hear Lawler saying, oh, they're just getting more, you know, finicky. No, they just don't care about Rollins. What do you not get?
Yeah, they're why were they saying that? They were like, oh, the crowd is real finicky. What? Go fuck
yourself.
And then
you tease everybody with a Walter match that goes 4 minutes, and you screw any fun that people are having by making it a stupid tag team here that no one gives a shit about. You bring out Owens, like you said, for the stunner and the crotch chop, and that's it. Andrade's match against, you know, Cedric Alexander is another waste. There's no story. There's no purpose to it. Andrade is another one that just builds up wins to go nowhere.
I really couldn't give a fuck.
We got the Lana segment. Eric Rowan was a joke. That was a minute match against Durson. I guess they're trying to just make him look like a extreme badass, but you didn't need that to do so. And then the joke of the tag match and the main event. And it all, you know, kind of came to a head or a boiling point with Orton. Will he turn on them? Won't he? And he made it so predictable at that point that it was a joke. Him trying to sell that, oh, I might attack with his plodding, boring, shitty in-ring style, you know, his no-fucks-given attitude, did nothing for anyone. And I'm sorry, I don't give two shits about Humberto. I know he's good in the ring, but he is a fucking wet noodle in terms of character.
Yeah, he sucks.
I think they're saying Alberto Del Rio when they announce him. The crowd doesn't give a shit about him. The fans don't accept him. They pushed him way too fast, too hard. And, you know, he was way too new for them to do that.
I'm shocked at how fast they pushed him out of nowhere.
Essentially just overnight. Here, you're going to go against Rollins. You're going to go against AJ multiple times. We're going to let you win this battle royal. And for what? No, there's nothing that wasn't a joke to me tonight, Andrade. Everything was ridiculous. There was not one semblance of entertaining TV here. At least SmackDown had a few rewarding moments or things that were, you know, a slight semblance of entertainment. But this was a joke through and through. I don't know a better way to describe it than that. That's the most my sick brain can come up with. It was abysmal. I originally was joking with a -1 comment, but, I mean, they did nothing to help the sale of Survivor Series. I mean, you figure they'd be focusing on Roderick Strong and Nakamura and AJ Styles more. Oh, well, you've got, you know, 1 week now to one show for Raw to do that. So that helps nothing here. You know, that you're having the Viking Raiders get these stupid wins against another babyface team, which gets them booed. That's not great when you're having them go and defend Raw against NXT and SmackDown. When you look at the Survivor Series card here, you know, they did nothing to push towards it.
Yeah, there's nothing to push towards or do. There's nothing to say. The bottom line is we're going to bed early. I don't care. I couldn't care about this show tonight. Obviously, a lot of people didn't care about the show tonight. There's way less people watching this show, my show tonight, than there ever have been because people went to bed or people are watching the Monday Night Football game.
They're watching Monday Night Football, which ended up being a great game so far.
It's not even over. They're going back and forth in overtime. This is crazy right now.
That has so much drama and tension to it, especially with undefeated season on the line.
Yeah.
It's going to be a huge ratings get.
I think Seattle's going to get it done here. I mean,
They always get it done.
They've made a million mistakes here and stupid ones, but I think they've got to do something here. They've got to do it.
I don't disagree. And on the side, no, I hate sounding negative because I've been trying to be more positive with other things, and no, people say I'm on drugs because of it.
This is the wrong night to say sorry. This is piece of shit tonight.
This was just a travesty for wrestling.
It was boring as hell.
And they know they're coming off of, you know, AEW's Dynamite Full Gear pay-per-view there. And,
well, they don't care.
They have things to compete with. And AEW isn't perfect either. I don't understand why they're doing SCU versus Jericho and Sammy Guevara for the tag titles.
But you know what? It's like it's way more interesting to talk about AEW, even some of the dumb things that AEW did the other day.
No argument there. I was confused when they announced they're going to have SCU take on Jericho and Guevara for the tag titles. That seems a little off. And then they're going to have the rubber match between Paige and Pac.
Right.
I think they're kind of killing that feud, but
I that Well, we've already been. I mean, I've already said what I said about AEW. I mean, that tag match to open the show, I mean, made no goddamn sense. Did you finally see it?
Yeah, I watched Sunday.
Dude, did you not see when the heels tagged in, but the referee didn't see it and then tried to hold them back?
I was referencing that earlier. That's what
the hell was the point
for
in that?
A heel team.
Why did they try to get sympathy for the heel team, but then the Young Bucks are still the faces? And then the Young Bucks lose the match and the heels win, and then the heels do heel things at the end, but then Ricky Morton comes in, and then that's obviously a big face moment. So why in the world, going back to that, did they have that situation that got the fans to boo the referee and to cheer for the bad guys?
And that was planned. That was not, because I said to you when I was watching, I was like, was that an accident? Like the ref missed it unintentionally? No, that was you know, totally a scripted moment.
Why?
Baffling. No idea why they went
like
that.
That was the dumbest thing that I've ever seen. I went, what am I watching? Why do they do that? Like, I would love to hear from them. Like, and I know that this is some people out there don't even know her. They're like, well, who cares or whatever. Like, what do you mean? It wouldn't matter to me if there was no heels or faces. Like, if it was just like, whatever, anything can happen. But that is a clear move to get heat on the other team and the referee. Seattle just nailed the field goal.
So now you need
Wait a minute. Did they hit the field goal?
Did they? I don't have it on right now.
It looked good to me, but neither referee signaled. I thought it was good, but neither referee signaled. Oh, did they? Oh, they called a timeout before the kick.
Oh Jesus! They iced him.
Wow, but not, it's like not only that.
Well, they tried to.
Wow, they went with the kick anyway. That was crazy.
Damn.
He hit it. I think he just hit it in the corner, but the referees.
Now you're gonna make him do it again.
Neither ref did anything. They just were like, "Oh, let's go get the ball," and then they showed the kicker still looking down at the ground. So I'm just assuming, yeah, they called the timeout right, and then he went with the kick anyway.
Damn.
What a bunch of cocksuckers!
That's brutal.
Let's see what he does. Here comes the real kick now. I guess.
Do it again.
Here comes the do it again. The kick is up. The kick is good. Seattle with three, and that's it. That's the game. Seattle Seahawks defeat the 49ers. Perfect season is over. Thank God. By the way, where are you at? Credit to me, motherfucker. The Ravens would upset the Patriots for the first time in the season, and the Seahawks would defeat the 49ers to end their perfect season.
Your picks were spot
fucking
on.
Suck my cock. I'm mad that I was right about the I picked against the Jake. I wasn't spot on. I did say the Ravens would be the toughest game the Patriots played, but I did pick the Patriots.
Oh,
so,
did you? I remember you saying they were the toughest.
I'm just fucking around. But no, I did. I did say that they would be the toughest, but I did not pick them. I did fuck up. I did.
Oh, I thought you did.
No, I'm just joking around. Yeah, I'm just fucking around, trying to be a cocksucker. Well, but I was close. But,
don't tell them that you're. You're
no,
still
exactly.
Perfect.
That's what I'm saying. I'm just make it all up. Just make it up right now.
You got
now.
The perfect picks.
Suck my dick, JB. Eat my asshole.
Yeah.
Dynamite
full gear.
Add Ryder and Sean's view. Nick says, bro, way too much.
Ryder and Sean's view. Yeah, I would definitely add Sean's view. Well, you know something, bro. Let me tell you, bro. Hey, bro. Hey, bro. Hey, Lo. Hey, Joe. What a game!
Finish it.
Calling it now, OC beats Viking Raiders for tag titles next week on Raw. Their win in Saudi earned a tag title shot, so we get OC v Undisputed v New Day at Survivor Series. Just so commentary can play up the three factions, Viking Raiders don't fit the match.
That's so retarded. But, I mean, dude, why society? I wouldn't even be surprised with the way they're booking, with everything sucking right now, to be honest. Why society?
Finish it. I am going to eat this sandwich right now.
Yeah.
Live on my stream.
Faction versus
the
faction
Popeye's
versus
chicken
faction.
Sandwich was better than
Raw. Makes sense what they're going for.
I'm going to eat this Popeye sandwich. You guys want to know what I do for working out? I swear to God, I do 15 sit-ups, and then I beat up a kid at the Walmart.
Super Jack.
That's what I do. Jack. Finish it.
Sad Lana Angle on YouTube gets more views than Raw.
Yeah, Lana, Corwin Eberle, if that was my wife, I would never let them do that. I'd be like, fuck you. I would quit. I would tell Vince McMahon to kiss my ass.
Walter Brock Bray should have been SS
Swear
match.
Swear to God. Yeah. Too sweet. Too gay. It's more like too gay. Lana, I want Lana to suck my asshole.
Super Chat Party.
Christian Rodriguez, shell shock.
Christian Rodriguez, man, what's up, Christian? Thank you very much, man. He didn't say anything, but he just dropped a $14.99 super chat. And Mr. Christian Rodriguez, you are the largest donator of the night, man. Rodriguez with the $14. Much appreciated, Christian Rodriguez. Buenos noches. Everybody in the chat, what's up? How you guys doing? Did you guys watch that game? Holy shit. 49ers, Seahawks, what in the world, dude? There's more to talk about there. There's more to talk about in the overtime of that football game than in WWE right now. Like, you talk about messing up multiple times but getting the ball back finally and then ended up doing something. And Russell Wilson ran the ball,
Super
see?
Super chat.
Throw it in the red
party.
Zone.
Seahawks wins. Super Bowl, here we go.
Super Bowl 54! Or whatever the fuck it is. I don't even know. William Jones. What up, William Jones? Bring it on, baby. Bring it on. I want the Patriots. I want the Patriots and Pete Carroll again? You want the Patriots and Pete Carroll again? Come on. Bring Pete Carroll's white-haired ass back into the Super Bowl. And let's fuck him up again. Let's make him be stupid again. Plus, he was an idiot when he was a coach for the Patriots back in the day, too. Man, when Pete Carroll was the coach of the Patriots, I wanted to fucking assassinate myself. He was a moron. God, I hated Pete Carroll back in 99 or 98? I don't fucking remember. It was right after Parcells. 99, maybe? I don't fucking remember. It was horrible. I know that. 97, 98, maybe 98, 99. God damn, I don't remember. William Jones, thank you. Oh, 937, I tried to take your call. Call back, I'll get you on here.
Yeah, I say so way too much. Like you said, he says bro, I say so. That's just a verbal tick of mine. That's how I string words and throw my sentences together.
Yeah.
It's a connection. Mm-hmm. I learned that when I went to speech therapy after the brain surgery. They teach you like triggers in order to connect your thoughts. So when I say so, it's like my brain rebooting to connect the next sentence.
Oh, right.
It's pretty cool, but you know, when you don't realize things.
Yeah,
that's
when you start to realize
how to like reform full sentences and whatnot.
It's like a setup word to start thinking, which is
weird. Exactly. Yeah, that's you know, a refresh.
But you didn't need that before, so it's like,
yeah,
what's going on there?
Mm-hmm.
That's crazy. Well, anyway, guys, I'm trying to take calls. People are calling, and again, it's doing that thing where we took one call earlier, and now it won't let us take calls.
Now
again.
It won't go through.
Yeah, very weird.
So, I was going to give Full Gear like a 6.5, and people were like, oh, that's low, but it all came down to me for those last two matches. Honestly, I really didn't care.
Well, those
for,
saved the show. If those didn't happen,
yeah,
like, we're done. Like, it's that
I
was
didn't
horrible.
Care for anything before that, honestly, and it's a sad state of affairs, but the women's division is hurting badly.
Oh, Christ. I'm
the
sorry.
The pre-show match was good.
Yeah, I know. Bea Priestley and Britt Baker.
That should have been on the main card.
They actually had a story, and like the match was okay. It was better than Rio and
comparatively, you know, speaking.
Freddie Mercury.
So I was surprised the way they did that, but it's unfortunate that a lot of the other things feel like they're not connecting. Shawn Spears and Janela was just, I don't know, lacking. Hangman Page.
I understood that. I understood that they just needed to get, you know, Sean out there, give him a win on the show.
Yeah, he desperately needed the win, but
I got it. That was all right. It was just like, okay. You know,
Janelle was starting to feel like that whipping boy. They're like, oh, you need a win? We're going to let you. You know, he feels like that's the one you're building up off of to get to your next feud.
Yeah, I don't know who they would have beaten, though, otherwise, because
that's the problem.
Everybody
the
can't
roster.
Be important, you know?
Yeah, and some people can still lose and look okay. And Janela, you know, he's got that ability, but he wants to be more than Mr. Hardcore, so they're going to have to really work with him to do so.
I think he just kind of has to have this wildness to him. If he has this wildness to him, that's fine. He can tween between, you know, like going through a few tables and having a regular match.
Yeah, I think, you know, he has to have that art of balance. But Cody's match was amazing, and I've been a big critic of his. You know, he's never been nearly one of my favorites. I love Jericho to pieces, but that match, so just enigmatic and well thought out. Busting himself open the hard way. It was 8 stitches and separating his, you know, the space between his ribs and all this shit he went through. Now, the heel turn was beyond obvious. We knew it was coming. But, and I swear that beer throw was a plant because, you know, the guy had the standard AEW shirt on and just from where he was with the plastic. But even still, it just perfectly encapsulated the hate the crowd was sending towards MJF.
Yeah.
It worked. Even if it was super obvious, it worked and it was executed very, very well.
Yeah, they did a great job.
Throw, the sad, you know, I'm so sorry, I didn't want to see you get destroyed. That was the best the walls have looked since WCW days. He had Cody in such an awkward position with the, you know, the Walls of Jericho lion tamer. It was brutal. That looked so painful. And you could see how you knew Cody was never going to give in. Having Cody's mom slap Jericho, tell him, you know, go fuck yourself. Just all of it was perfect. Great, great match there. And I was surprised as how many people were either revolted or sickened by the dark match, the real main event, saying that, oh, it went too far. I don't know about you, but I've seen eons worse as far as death matches go. And a lot of that was really safe. It was like super safe stuff. The barbed wire on the bat, there were certain parts that was real. Same thing with the broom, because you know they were cutting themselves.
Yeah.
But the spider web they went into wasn't real barbed wire. That wasn't real glass on the ground.
Yeah.
I think the
worst
thing...
It was sugar glass. It was like sugar.
The chain hanging from it, you know, the way he's holding on to it, going through the light.
Why did people think this was some brutally crazy match? It really was...
I mean, it was hardcore, and they sold the hell out of it.
It was hardcore, but it wasn't CZW or anything.
No, exactly. They weren't actually filleting their scalps open and staple gunning each other and going through, you know, the light tube with thick nails on fire. Like, I've seen some explosives go off where people actually singe second and third degree, burn their bodies.
To me, this was like if you looked at Stone Cold and Bret Hart at WrestleMania 13 and you were like, let's up that a little bit. Like, to me, that's kind of what I felt about this. Like, it was like a more hardcore version of that. I had no problem with this. I don't know what people thought about gore and violence. And
yeah, the mousetrap spot was really cool.
Yeah.
I thought that was pretty ingenious, especially setting that whole thing up. And knowing that this is what they planned for each other, the Elite coming out and having them bring out the you know, barbed wire spider setup and being like, go get that
was
for
awesome.
Me. I'm using it. That was such a cool moment. And especially the way, like, we're not doing it. And he's like, God damn it. You know, he's forcing his friends to go and get his created death contraption. I think the worst spot of it all was when the ring was all tore up and he missed the splash and landed flush.
Yeah.
Omega, when he came down, that was the scariest hit of them all.
That was awesome. Dude, he hit his face off the wood on a Phoenix splash that he missed on. Like, it was like, he just did a Phoenix splash onto the wood. Like, it was so fucking hilarious.
That was brutal. And the paradigm shift and what a great match. These two, it went a little long, but still it needed to be there and super intense. And it I don't want to say reinvents, but it reinvigorates the character of Jon Moxley. It shows how, even though this was unsanctioned, the win didn't matter. It showed what both men would go through and to get victory and you know, totally decimate their opponent. The only problem I have with this is now on Wednesday, we're going to see Kenny Omega take a super kick and get pinned, you know, like that kind of thing, or Moxley can just take a DDT and lose a match. We saw these guys kick out of finishers through glass and barbed wire. And so that's the problem. You know, they're going to have to find that real art of balance with that stuff.
Well, I mean, I don't know. We'll get into it. Meltzer said he never wants to see that again. Meltzer, what?
Who are Meltzer these people? Yeah, Meltzer was going off and said it was, like, you know, super egregious. What? And he's like, it was brutal, but I didn't, you know, he liked it, but he never wanted to see it again. And
that's just, what do you mean you never want to see that again? I want to see that every once in a while. I'm not
they
even.
He said it was like senselessly violent and unnecessary.
What are you talking about? Like,
I don't feel like any of that was unsafe or too much.
The pogo sticking off all the ropes and flips everywhere is more dangerous than kind of what they did. Like, it's, I can't believe that. People are dumb.
I mean, so, they roughed themselves up. Omega's, you know, legit injured. He's not cleared for Wednesday. And,
yep.
But they said, you know, right off the bat, you had him say, oh, you know, Moxley's going through it, that you want to see some trash wrestling. Here we go. Here we fucking go. So,
Matt the Misfit's on the phone with us. We were able to get him on because he has a Skype name. Hey, Matt.
Hey, can you guys hear me?
Yeah.
All right, just making sure because Skype hates me for some reason.
Skype is broken. There's something wrong. We can't even take. I want to take phone calls. I can't even take phone calls.
Yeah,
Skype
is so broken. You guys were talking about AEW, dude. Outside of the two like last matches, I gave like zero shits about that show.
Yeah, it was bad.
If I was rating it from 5 out of 5, I'm gonna go with a like a 2.
Yeah,
maybe a 3 just because of the two main events.
And see, if you go with 3, that's people, a 6. That's what we. I gave it a 6.5. I think Joe did as well. So.
Yeah, I gave it that because, and I gave it a little extra because the last two matches were so good. But everything before the last two matches was like a 5.
And if those people that didn't like the Moxley Omega match are the same people who want the Attitude Era back, fuck yourselves. You do not need the Attitude Era back.
That's true. That's a great point because there's so many people that say, you know, oh, I missed the Attitude Era. Then you get that stuff, and they're like, oh, think of the children. Are you kidding me?
Like I fucking LOL'd when he brought out the mouse traps.
Yeah, yeah, I did as well. That made me, I was like, oh, shit.
I haven't seen that. I mean, you've seen that in, like, fucking and like, here's the outlaw issue shows and stuff.
And here's the issue about that. The people complaining about this is the same people that wanted the old John Moxley back, and you got him on Saturday night.
Yep. What are they talking about? Yeah, I don't understand. Anybody criticizing that match is a moron. I mean,
fucking
like,
love that. If I'm being honest with you, that was more unsanctioned than the one he did with Janela.
Oh, yeah. No, yeah. They went. I mean, much. Well, the one with Janela had more, like, you know, aerial stuff, like, and things like that. Like,
that had more wrestling, which I think some people wanted to see a bit more wrestling in this one, but that wasn't the story here.
And I'm going to give fucking credit to John Moxley, to Kenny Omega. He fucking brought it. He went to that level of what he didn't have to.
Right.
And, also, I'm going to give Omega credit. He's put over Pac, Moxley, and Jericho in 2019, and he did not have to do that.
Right.
So, well, credit to him.
He's putting over everybody and making it look good, no doubt.
And then Raw was a piece of shit show.
Oh, yeah, this was... I don't even...
I mean, first of all, Scotty Styles, you fucking idiot on Twitter who thought the Lana pregnancy is real... and said that they would not fake a pregnancy angle in 2010. You look like the biggest fucking moron I've ever seen in my life.
Especially when she walks out at the end and says, hey.
Oh, sorry, Scotty.
I'm like, Jesus Christ. And by the way, Seth Rollins was not the legal man in that main event, by the way, when he pinned Alexander Wolf.
You know, I wondered about that, but I was like, maybe I don't even care.
I'm just throwing it out there.
Fucking, that's hilarious. If that's true, that's funny.
And fuck the New Day. I said it earlier with Jake. It should be the Revival versus War Raiders and Undisputed Era. I mean, you could do that match anytime you want with New Day and Undisputed Era. It doesn't really matter.
Did you see Jobber Knocker Wrestling Podcast who tweeted out, wonder Mike and Kanellis vetoed this shitty angle only to have Rusev and Lana and Lashley subbed in.
That's fucking hilarious.
That's basically it.
Let's see. The Nakamura Styles and Roderick Strong match is going to be fantastic if they give them time. Baszler and fucking Becky is going to be... I'm looking forward to that. I feel bad for Bayley, really. Let's see. What else? Will Adam Cole defend his title since the other two are going to be defending the title? That's what I'm wondering. Or is he going to be part of the Survivor Series match?
I have no idea. We don't know. I think we thought Bray was going to face Daniel Bryan, right?
Well, apparently WWE tweeted out, or WWE on Fox tweeted out or something that Bray Wyatt is going to be on SmackDown this week. And they said The Fiend. They didn't say just Bray Wyatt. They said The Fiend, so I don't know what that means.
All right. Well, that'll be interesting.
So, But I'm actually excited for Daniel Bryan versus Bray Wyatt. Because if it's anything like their match at SummerSlam, what fucking paper?
Royal Rumble.
Yeah.
That was fucking
fantastic. A classic and a half. And that's the thing. Like, they have so much story and history that they're going to build off of this with the Funhouse. They have plans.
I love it.
I just hope they go through with it, you know, but in a way, if it means we're going to get it for longer and like fully fleshed out, then let them just have face the Miz.
But it's also
in Survivor Series.
Why isn't Daniel, you know, imagine if Daniel Bryan was a heel still, how much it would get Bray over. Instead, it's
It would be even better. And especially that Daniel Bryan better serves this role as well.
Well, here's the thing. I think they're going to put Daniel Bryan in the spot because they want to get, I wonder if they want to actually have Bray like booed now. I don't know.
I mean, they're dumb because their people are going to just cheer him, and they're going to cheer him in this, and Daniel Bryan will be a face that loses to Bray, and they'll cheer for Bray. So, yeah,
the one thing I am looking forward
to. But again,
to,
now it's another face-face thing, like the Kabuki Warriors. It's like you're confusing the fans again because it's like they don't want to cheer for him.
I mean, it's weird for that one because they're supposedly supposed to be building up the Asuka Becky thing, which okay, but why is Charlotte there? What the fuck? Didn't she not team with Natalia like Natty 2 weeks ago?
Yeah, well, I guess Natalia. I just had somebody tell me that they did mention on the show, but I guess it is legit. She had some family things, so she couldn't.
What about
go ahead
last
and make
week?
It.
What about last week?
I don't know, but for the title this week, you know, because her and Natalia teamed up beforehand, so that's
all well and good for this week. But what happened last week? What the fuck was she last week? Everyone was accounting for. I don't know.
I'm telling you.
But Wednesday nights, I can't wait for Wednesday nights. You got the fallout from Moxley and Omega. You got the. Weirdly enough, they're getting Jericho and Sammy Guevara is getting a AEW tag team title match for some odd reason.
Yeah, I tweeted that earlier. I was really surprised. I mean, and then we're getting more of, you know, Pac and Paige. I know it's the rubber match. People keep saying it, but I feel like it's too soon. We just saw it. Hold off for a little bit and you know, go back to this after the fact. Like, it doesn't have to be 1, 2, 3 with this, I feel. But
what I got out of that was it's obvious whoever wins out of that match between Pac and Paige is getting the next shot at the AEW title.
Yeah, I had said that for the predictions on out of nowhere. That
I thought Pac was going to win. But then I thought about it. I'm like, but if Pac wins, that means Cody would have to win the title because they're not going to do heel versus heel.
So, well, I mean, it depends on what they do going forward. They can have Pac win again and because I don't know if they're going to go back to Paige and Jericho.
Well, they probably will because, like, where do you go from, like, what do you do with Jericho next, right?
Well, I think they're going to stay away. My personal opinion, I think we're going to see more of, you know, faction versus faction, the elite versus the inner circle.
Good point, yeah.
I think that's what we're going to get coming up next.
Well, how's it going to be,
especially if they're having them go for the, you know, the tag titles now, and they're going to start showing them as a unit.
Well, that's if. Omega is done with Moxley. That's the thing.
They're doing their own Survivor
Omega's
Series.
Omega's injured now, too, so they're probably going to need some time in between.
Well, I would be injured, too, after that fucking match.
Yeah. I think they're going to need some time to let him heal and same thing with Moxley, and then go ahead and they can build into this, and Moxley could be the X Factor.
Yeah, fucking Renee Young was fucking... She tweeted that during that match.
I saw him after the fact the next day that she was not a happy camper, but...
I thought that shit was hilarious. I'm like, well...
Yeah, NXT Wednesday, they got, you know, Shirai against Mia Yim, and that's for advantage in the War Games match. So at least they're building to their own pay-per-view, and
Mia
that
Yim
also...
screwed over. I'm calling it right now. Mia Yim's
I think so as well, and that's what they're trying to...
Ty's going to join Sheena Baszler's team.
Yeah, I agree. And then Leo Rush is taking on Angel Garza for the Cruiserweight Championship.
I haven't got to ask you this, because I haven't been able to call in for a few weeks now, because fucking Skype... fucking is bullshit.
Yes,
but how do you guys feel about a second War Games match at TakeOver?
I'm all for it. I know you're not crazy about it.
I wish they'd do one on the main roster at this point.
Yeah, really. But I like the fact, like you said, one of them feels pointless, and like, I don't remember your explanation.
That one is actually makes sense.
Yeah.
The men's is just happening just to happen.
Which I think is okay, because if they only had the women's, even though the women's makes sense, then people would say, oh, you're leaving the men off the card for the women, and it feels too SJW, so they have to have that kind of be equal.
Well, NXT knows what they're doing, so I'm
Yeah, you wouldn't call it that. You know, because like, there's a story in the women's match that makes good sense, so let's go with this.
And pretty much everyone in that match supposedly hates Shayna Baszler. So
that's exactly it. But if they didn't have the men's, too many people would be like, oh, fucking bullshit. God damn it, Ryback, get out of the chat.
I'm seriously like, why? Why is Ryback in the chat? God damn it.
Because I thought with the men, you were going to have like, you know, probably Undisputed Era defend their titles, Adam Cole versus... I'm almost positive that they're doing... what the fuck is that? Gargano, and I'm calling him Prince Devitt. I'm not calling him Finn Balor.
He's not. But I think so too. I think that's what's going to happen. We'll get Cole and
so who's going to be the fourth guy for Ciampa's team? I'm actually trying to figure that, because it's not going to be Velveteen Dream.
Christ, man.
No, Dream's injured. So
hey, Matt, if you ask a question, like, wait till the person answers it. The fuck is wrong with you?
I haven't called in like weeks.
I know, but you're just like, you're throwing, you're like, hey, so what do you think if this happens? And then like Jake goes to, well, you know, oh, but yeah, but then in this other match, like, the fuck is the point in asking a question?
I just like calling in guys.
I know, I love you, but it's just like, it's hilarious. You're ready to go. You just fucking, you're like, I'm going to ask all the questions and then they can answer them later.
Fucking Ryback. He's still in the chat.
Ryback? I'm going to flip
him. He wants that damn chicken sandwich.
Ryback fall off a cliff and just, like, I don't know, get eaten by a fucking alligator or something.
I'm gonna rape Donovan Dijakovic. I'm going to rape him.
Anyway, I'm going to let you guys go.
You're a faggot.
Ryback, you bastard.
Matt the Misfit eats dick. Take my supplements, faggot. Go ahead, finish it.
Ryback's got
take my fucking supplements. No, seriously, I swear to God, Matt the Misfit, are you fucking? Are you still on the phone?
Why does Ryback sound like
you still here?
Fucking damn!
I am gonna fucking shell shock you.
Why does it sound like it got shelled down his throat?
gurgle.
I swear, he feels like he has something wrong with him. He sounds like fucking Christian Bale on fucking steroids.
I am going to break your arm, and then I'm going to hang you upside down like a lantern.
You guys remember when Christian Bale was Batman? That's what he sounds like right now.
Do you do you remember when I broke your legs? Snap, crackle, pop, finish it.
Yeah.
Wake up.
Damn, you're right back.
Feeding time.
Well, I mean, after Raw, I would love to be awake, but.
Yeah. You asshole.
Man, Ryback is such a rude person.
I know. He's got no chill.
I will rape you. I swear to God, I'll rape you.
I think Ryback's hangry. He's just too hungry and angry.
Shut up. More. You want to go do this? You want to do this right now? I am Ryback Ryan Reeves, and I need more. More. Feed me more nutrition. Available at thebigguy.com. Ryback, feed me more energy. It will keep you going through the day. You'll be able to go to work. You'll be able to masturbate on the break, come back and do all your work that you need to do, because I am the big guy Ryback. And when you feed yourself more of my supplements available on Amazon right now, you will become energized and you will get the job done just like the big guy does, okay? Just like the big guy does, all right? Finish it. Feed me more energy. Big guy. Use your Amazon Prime account to get the best supplements in the world. Shell Shock. Fat Body Extreme. Fat Burner will burn all the fat in your cock.
I'm sorry. I don't lie.
Ryback's such a uncouth
bastard. I cut a great promo for him.
Rumor is Brian taking title off Nakamura this week.
Wow. Brian takes... Yeah, we heard about that, actually. That could be... that's weird, though, but yeah, it could be.
Finish I've heard the same, it. But...
Ryback.
Then you got Nakamura, Roderick Strong. And...
Dude, I should do Ryback's promos for him on his goddamn website. X, thanks for subbing, man. X, go give it to you, subscribe. I can't even do DMX right now because my voice is fucked up, but thank you for subscribing.
What? My name is Kane and I'm donating.
My God, it's Kane.
Hey guys. Man oh man, Raw was abysmal. Even my mother doesn't like the Lana Rusev storyline. Great hot song to start the show. Did you see I upped my Patreon to produce a statues?
I did, Kalelbama. In fact, that was on my radar right now. Kalelbama went from the 14 spot up to the $25 producer level. Also, Kalelbama. Kalel baby. Everybody give Kalel some love in the chat because he's keeping these shows on the air like many of you guys. Lydia Taylor, also Lydia, thanks for becoming a $5 Cronin Club member. And Eugene, welcome back. Kevin Fox, welcome to the Patreon as well. Thank you to Kevin. And Salman Rahani, thanks for the $5. Joe Latimer, $1. Russ Alot as well is here. Timothy and CJ Bradley's
a
producer.
Bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Want some bubbly?
Bubbly.
Look at this stuff.
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
I want to slurp China's dead corpse bath water.
Whoa. Jesus Christ. Oh my God, dude. Holy shit. That's
Makes
fucked up.
Money off that one.
I am now going to turn into video game mode for a little bit and see if it how it goes, man. That is really fucked up. Wow. That's fucked up. Where's the Ryback sex line call from Monetize this a little while back? That was pretty good. Six-speed Stang. What up, six-speed Stang? That's fucking hot. Jake, anything you want to say, man, before we get the fuck out of here with all this?
Fuck Raw. I'm looking forward to NXT and AEW Wednesday. I think it'll be good shows. I mean, even if I'm not crazy about the booking, I'm still, like, you know, logic out the window. I still look forward to seeing Guevara and Jericho take on SCU. That's going to be fun. So
yeah, that's going to be cool. I mean, I guess.
It should be
a good
time,
it might be.
You know,
I mean,
regardless.
AEW's been weird on Wednesdays. It's been good every time. It's just, I wonder what we're going to get. Are we going to get another epic show? Or are we going to get one that's like, okay, that was all right, I guess. It's either all right, I guess, pretty good, or it's awesome.
But I think because they're going to start branching out and doing some different feuds, it seems, with a few of the, you know, undercard stuff. Hopefully it's damn good.
Yeah, I hope it's good, man. I really do. I think it can be, but...
Again, I apologize for my shitty voice. I didn't want to drive people nuts, but I didn't want a no-show tonight with this awful show. We had to at least bitch about it.
I don't know
bit.
What I would have just taken calls, because at least the calls would have worked then, and I would have just rambled through calls. But obviously there's something wrong with Skype and we can't take calls. There's a problem.
Fucking Skype.
Fuck you, Skype, in the ass.
Tiffany didn't even see Raw and she's still here. That's what a lot of people said. They said, we're not even watching. We're just going to show up to the review.
Yeah, and you know, and sometimes that's fun to do because I have like an epic meltdown, so at least you can laugh at that. This was one of those nights where even if you showed up to my Raw review, I didn't have much for you either because this show just murdered my life. Like, this show just killed me. It made me want to be dead inside. And I had no fun tonight. It was misery.
Like, that's the thing. Like, even on a bad night, you can still turn it into gold somehow by, you know, like you said, having an epic rant or, you know, lamenting the fact that you had to watch this shit.
Yeah.
But with the way everything worked out tonight, it was just like, I have no energy to want to rip it apart. I just hated it. It was just pure hate.
Yeah, it was just boring. It was boredom. Nothing interesting to suggest in place of what they did. Nothing I could really, for the most part, pick apart from it. But what I can do is, while I get ready to play video games, I can hang up on Jake and play Ryback's sex line call. Jake, you have a good night, man. Thanks for being here. At Countdown Ended on Twitter. Check out his YouTube channel at Countdown Ended on YouTube. And got some new podcasts up this week, so check out Jake's channel for that. And
yeah, fucking YouTube, they're like, oh, hey, you got Super Chats over the weekend. I was like, oh, that's cool.
Oh, that's
you
cool.
Because I had the subscribers finally in the watch time. I was like, all right, good. So then today I get an email. It's like, oh, you need watch time. And they had reset my watch time back to zero. So now I need to reestablish that all over again.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
No idea why that was. So I got essentially monetized and then lost that ability in 24 hours.
Jesus Christ. We should probably we should do one stream over there, and it would, you'd get all the hours in one stream.
Fucking ridiculous. Gotta love YouTube.
Here's Ryback right there. Emoji King. It wouldn't even, I don't know if Emoji King tried to write emojis, but it wouldn't let him do it, probably because he would have been banned from YouTube or whatever. With that glitch that's going on. Emoji King, thank you.
It tried.
Oh, it's Y Society, too. All right, Jake, man, you have a good night.
All righty. Everybody, take it easy. Stay sexy.
See you, Jake.
Go drink that bath water.
I'm going on Twitch. Everybody, I'm going to Twitch. Come on over to Twitch. I am going to Twitch. I'm staying live on YouTube, though, right now. Here is the Ryback.
It's finish it.
Ryback had a little phone call.
It's me, Sean.
Introduce yourself. Sounds like a good night to me.
Getting really... Well, yeah, I'm getting fucked up. Shell shock.
Well, I like that you're getting fucked up.
Yeah,
what do you usually think about when you're getting fucked up like this?
I get really fucked up, and then I get... And then I get... I give it to you, and I give you the shell shock.
Yeah, what's that?
Yeah, it's when I pick you up and I put you down, but on my dick.
That sounds pretty good.
Yeah. I'm Rose. Ryback Rose.
Ryback Rose.
What the Ryback fuck? What?
Ryback Rose.
Yeah, I saw your name was Adam Rose, so I...
Yeah,
that's what your name was.
I go by Ryback Rose, but yeah, Adam was a... That's my real name, but I go by Ryback Rose. I feel it's... I just like people calling me that. I knew a guy named Ryback once, and I always honor him everywhere with the name, the screen name.
Go by Dave Rose.
Hell yeah.
Oh, wow, why'd you like Ryback Rose so much?
Something about it gets me fired up. Like, I get fired up in the bed and I start pounding it, like, fucking just smashing it in there, positivity into the pussy.
He come to my eyes once.
Oh, my God.
Wow,
heard to buy your muscle powder.
Good, right?
I'm fired up right now. I'm ready to explode your pussy and show your daddy issues to the world.
Yeah, you ready to what?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
I'm gonna expose all you. I'm gonna fuck your daddy. I'm gonna fuck the daddy issues out of you. That's what I'm talking about.
Oh no.
Sell us some diet pills.
Yeah. I just wanna smash it up. Finish it.
Smash it up. Come on, what are you waiting for?
Advertise your channel.
Yeah, my name is I got a YouTube channel. Twitter. I got a Twitter. I'm on Facebook. Anybody can hit me up. I mean, listen, I'd rather stay on the call with you here, though, if we could keep it here, because the last girl was like trying to get me to fucking, I don't know, like email her or something. I'm like, no, I don't do that. I do like, I don't do email. I do phone calls.
Oh, cool. Well, I have the same mentality.
Yeah, I'm going to mentally fuck you up.
Oh, yeah? How so?
Yeah, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put on a gorilla suit and I'm going to tickle your fucking grundle.
Oh, God.
What's my grundle?
You know what's ready? I'm going to tongue you down. Yeah. Nah. Ryback TV. Finish it.
There's the advertisement.
Fuck yeah.
Well,
do the Ryback noise.
Tongue me, but
fuck yeah.
Don't know what a gondola is.
That's the spot under your fucking right. Oh my god, you don't know what it is? Oh my god, I'm gonna fucking say Grundle again. Say Grundle again, please.
Why should I?
Oh.
If you want to explain what it is, why should I say it?
Yeah. Oh, I'm so close. Say, it's the spot. It's right under your fucking, like, the little taint spot under your ass and between your pussy and your ass. That spot up in there. You know, you like sometimes.
Oh, my God.
Come on, say fucking fit into my grundle.
Pit of spikes.
Oh my god.
I think you should say it. Oh, you want to live.
Oh, it's time. Ryback roar.
You're the one roaring.
How are you going to put her in a pit of cock?
I'm going to put you in a... I'm going to put you in a pit of cocks. Have you ever been... I'm going to put you in a pit of cocks. Pit of cock.
My God, deity.
Pit of cocks. Finish. Yeah. Tell me you want me to finish it. Tell me you want me to finish you. Finish it.
Why? Are you like Hulk Hogan or something?
No.
Ryback.
No, my name is Ryback. My name is Ryback.
No, I know what your name is.
You cunt.
I mean, that sounds like a stupid, stage name anyway.
Yeah, well, this is being recorded for your information. It's not a stage name, it's real. Hulk Hogan's a cunt. I am going to finish in it.
Then why do you both act and sound the same?
I don't sound, what the fuck? I don't sound anything like Hulk Hogan. I don't sound, do you want me to do my impression of Hulk Hogan right now for you?
If you want, yeah.
Well, I'm going to show you why you're fucking fucked.
Okay.
All right, well, this is Hulk Hogan. Are you ready? My name is Ryback Ryan, Dave Rose, Ryback Ryan. All right? But here's fucking Hulk Hogan. He's like this. Well, you know something, dude? Hulkamania's running wild all over you, brother. And today, Hulkamania's going to say something really fucked up, dude. Like, Devious Dave Rose is a fag, brother.
That literally sounds exactly the same.
I don't sound like. What the fuck? Are you kidding me right now? Really? What the fuck are you saying right now? I don't even believe. What? I call. I paid $20 so some girl can call me fucking Hulk Hogan. Hulk fucking Hogan. That guy sucks dick.
Well,
try to sell her some muscle powder.
Maybe you suck dick too. He does. I mean, he's pound away.
I do not, let me, oh my god, I'm really gonna fucking freak out. I'm really gonna freak the fuck out. I sound nothing like Hulk Hogan.
Oh, you're gonna Hulk out? You're gonna Hulk out?
What the fuck are you saying to me right now? Oh my god, you're really fucking, oh my god, I'll never get hard again. I will never get hard again. This is so fucked up. Just say Grundle again. I wanna get back. Let me tell you something. Have you ever had Fat Body Extreme?
Fat Body Extreme?
Yeah.
That was
yeah. How about fucking you never had any products? I've got so many on my Amazon account. Fat Burner.
No, I haven't. What's that?
Fat Burner. You can burn with nutrition. You can burn fat. Shell Shock Extreme Fat Burner. It's the number one natural supplement for your body, the big guy bodybuilding testosterone booster for men. Tell all the men in your life, if they buy this, you will be fucked like you wouldn't believe.
Sure.
Yeah, swear to God.
Buy it,
I swear to God, I'm in Vegas. I'm in Vegas. When I'm telling you. Shell Shock Fat Burner. Hashtag the number one all natural fat burner. I don't know why I read the hashtag, but I'm sorry I read the hashtag. Just there's number one. That's all you gotta remember is number one. All natural fat burner with apple cider vinegar, Capsimax, green tea, green coffee bean. It's carcinogenic, it's acai berry, 30 servings. It's gonna fucking make your male partner just grow.
Well,
yeah.
I think you guys should definitely take part in
Fuck
that.
Yeah. You know it. Finish it. I will finish on you if you take Shell Shock Extreme Fat Burner.
Well, maybe I should order some then.
Absolutely. Order it all up. Order it. I will suck. Bitch. I will fucking suck every last drop out of your pussy. I will do that.
You're on fire.
That sounds good.
Oh, baby.
I'll look up your Amazon.
I gotta be honest. I really do. Like, I'm so fucking drunk right now that I am spazzing out a little bit, and I apologize for that. But can you please fucking, please just say Grundle again for me, please? Could you do that?
You wanna play with that Grundle?
Oh, yeah. Fuck yeah.
One time only offer, 20% off one, to suck my dick.
One time only offer to suck. Oh, say Grundle again. I'm almost there. I'm ready to go. Finish it. Shell Shock.
Come on. Oh, yeah. You want to.
Fuck Shell's pussy hole.
Oh, no. Oh, no. I'm sorry.
Oh, my God.
I'm sorry, Shell. I'm sorry.
He just went through the fucking Shell gusto right there.
Oh, Shell my Shock. God. I'm so dead right now.
I'm kidding.
Yo, oh, that was amazing.
You could have went on another 10 minutes.
Yeah, bro, she was pretty good.
She wasn't hanging up for anything. The cunt you've had in the past couldn't handle shit.
Yeah,
I
that
want
girl.
You to eat, I she want to play with my Grundle.
Please, I want you to play with my Grundle,
dude. Fuck,
could you imagine how much better horse curd would have been if she would have been the one to get Oscar horse curd?
Horse curd.
Oh, horse curd.
I said horse curd.
I
wasn't
playing my
voice. Well, that was certainly a fun night. That was one of the sex line calls on Monetize This. If anybody wants to download that Ryback clip, the whole clip on audio file, here's the link in the chat to that link on Patreon from the original post from weeks back. If you're a patron, you can easily see it. If you're not a patron, you'll have to become a patron, but there's the link for you. In case you were wondering, I gotta sell something, right? Come on, otherwise I can't keep doing these shows.
Super chat.
What the hell? It didn't play my emojis, peach eggplant.
I know, that was so weird. Why society? I don't know what happened. It was just all blank. I have no idea why that happened. Why society? But thank you for the donation, and thanks to everybody who's checking out Twitch. I'm live on Twitch right now. Twitch.tv/JoeCronin. JCS, we are live on the Purple Place. And we got more from Rybotch. Is there any more from Rybotch? Yeah, it looks like there is. Here's another shot from Rybotch.
End the fuck over.
But no, he still didn't want to do that.
Yeah, because nothing he was saying was logical. Chat.
Oh my god, I'm crying.
Spaz
right
Phoenix.
JD would be Ryback's prison wife.
Oh my god.
Get down. Shut up.
What are you doing, bro? What are you doing to me, bro?
Shut the fuck up. Shut your mouth. What's your name? Wait, tell me what's your name.
My name is JD.
Shut the fuck up.
But you told me.
Shut up. Bend over. I want you to bend the fuck over.
My cat's on my lap, though. I don't want to bend over.
Shut up and bend over.
Okay.
Oh
my god, my ass! What are you doing to my ass?
Oh, yeah. Oh, shell shock. Finish it.
Oh, my God, don't finish it. Please don't finish it.
I'm going to finish it. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, my God. I'm going to fucking die right now. Oh, yeah, yeah,
yeah. Here's some more Ryback. Rybotch. Rybotch.
Hello, sir. Welcome to Moriarty's. Is it a table for one, or are there more in the party coming?
I am here for one reason, and one reason only. To finish in it.
Okay, we can get you a table over here, or near the fish tank, if you'd like that. Would that be
something?
Come here. Sir, why are you grabbing me?
Oh, yeah. Shell-shocked.
Sir, what the hell are you doing, sir? Sir, please stop. Oh, yeah.
Finish in it. Finish in it.
Oh, my God, sir. Goodness, what are you doing? Yeah. What are you doing?
Jesus. He just raped that guy. Holy Christ. I'm sorry. I'm weird. Oh, Welfare Bandit Tony, thank you for hosting me on... What's up, bro? Thanks for hosting me on Twitch, man. I much appreciate it. I'm gonna play some Diablo 3 tonight. I'm just gonna hang out for a little while longer. I did put up an episode of Morning Madness yesterday. If you haven't seen that, go check it out. Hope you enjoy it. It's a good time. It's up for all the patrons on patreon.com/JoeCroninShow. My Patreon link is down below. It can keep the show going. You get a bunch of bonus content you can't really hear on YouTube. I'm almost 30 hours a month that you don't hear at all on YouTube for the most part. So feel free to go check that out, support the channel, but also you get all that content. So check it out. That's like the noise I make whenever I'm like doing something. I'm trying to like get through it. I'm like, da-da-da-da-da. Like, what the fuck is that? I've noticed I do that all the time. We didn't actually come close to the goal tonight. We normally blow the goal away. Normally on shows, the goal gets blown away, but we did fail the goal tonight. I will say that. That's how bad Raw was, though. You know what I mean? Like, most people just assumed, like, yeah, I'm not even fucking going to sleep, or I'm watching Monday Night Football. I blame Raw on the reason why the goal wasn't met tonight, to be honest. I really do. I think it's Raw's fault. I'm blaming Raw. That and a poor recession or something. I don't know. But no, I'm mostly blaming Raw. I'm mostly blaming Raw. Shrink that a little bit. Put it over here. Expand the window. What's the challenge rift this week? I haven't done the challenge rift. I did the monk. The monk last week was so easy, it was ridiculous. Oh, this is probably going to... Well, I hope this is easy, because I'm not even going to study it. I'm just going to go in and mash buttons and try to beat it. What up, Ben Ashes in the chat on Twitch? What's up to the Twitch chat? How you guys doing? It's post-show time. Raw was horrible. We did get above 1,000 viewers, David. Yeah, we did. We were at 1,000 something tonight was the peak current. So we still nailed over 1,000. 1,049 was the peak current tonight, so... Even though Raw was like the most boring ever, we still had a peak viewership of 1,049, which is really good for a shithole tonight, and an average viewership of 15 minutes and 55 seconds, which is also good. So that's pretty good, and 7,000 playbacks. So 7,000 people came in at some point. So that's pretty goddamn good for a horrible night, I would say. So not bad. All right, everybody, if you don't come over to Patreon for all the bonus stuff over there tonight, Come on over to the Purple Place. I'm live right now on the Purple Place, and that is Twitch. Don't want to say it too much for the algorithm to hear me talking about the bad guys, but I'm over there right now, and I'm going to be gaming and talking for a little bit. I don't know how long. I could be playing for 15 minutes. I could be playing for 3 hours. You never know with these things, but I'm going over there. So come on over, join me, and we'll have a good time. I much appreciate it. Again, thanks for the host. You guys can drop bits over there if you want, whatever you'd like to do. But let's go, man. We might be able to get over 100 people over there. Right now we got 30. We could probably do over 100, I think. I think we could do it. We're rocking it right now. We're rocking it right now. The chat's lit. We've hit over 77,000 views on Twitch. That's cool. We got over 47 subs. You can subscribe over there for free, and I get $3. If you're an Amazon Prime member, you get one free sub to somebody a month. And you can subscribe to me. It's free for you to do, and I get $3 or something. It's pretty cool. So if you want to support the channel and you have no money but you have an Amazon account, it's free. So you guys can subscribe. We might hit 50 subs tonight maybe if you do that. So come on over, everybody on YouTube. Check it out. Get wet. And we'll see what happens. Man, there's some crazy, awful shit going on in Gaza. What the hell's going on? In Israel and shit? Schools are closed? That's crazy. Drew just told me about that. Wow. That's scary for them. That's fucked up. All right, guys. Come meet me over on Twitch, man. Good night, everybody. Thanks for being here. Thank you for everybody who donated. And shout out, I believe, to the largest donator, who was Christian Rodriguez. Christian Rodriguez, thank you very much. I believe you were the top donator tonight at $14.99, man. Thank you so much. It was a quiet night, but we'll be back tomorrow night on my other channel, Corrupted Nation, with Tuesday Night Throwdown tomorrow night. Wednesday night will be the AEW review. Thursday night will be Thursday Night Out of Nowhere, live right here at 11 p.m. Friday night will be Monetize This over on the Corrupted Nation channel, where you can hear skits like that Rybotch one. And Saturday night, once again, Corrupted Podcast, which is up now on Patreon. 3 hours almost. Pretty good stuff over there. Bye, YouTube. We'll see you later, YouTube.